say to the parent who has 19 or 20 years old?
Then go out.
And, you know, to convince him that the person needs to get married. I mean, how can you convince a parent that a 19 years old or 20 years old, already able to go to college, and is the right time now to get married?
You know, let me tell you a story. The question was, how do you convince a parent of a 20-year-old that their kid needs to get married early? Especially if you notice something and they don't notice it. So there was a story like that. The mom tells the mother, I think you need to get your daughter married early. She says, no, she's too young, she's just, 19. She needs to get married now. He says, okay, let me show you something. Opens up Facebook. The daughter, Muslim family, daughter went to the prom. She was the prom queen. Parents had no idea. She was the worst dressed of even the non-Muslims. And there's hundreds of pictures of her on Facebook. The mother sees it and can't believe her eyes. She can't believe her eyes. Why? Because our parents are completely oblivious to reality. They have no idea what's going on in the kids' lives. They don't. They assume if my child doesn't tell me there's a problem, there is no problem. They assume if my kid says they're going to the library, they're at the library. Right? This is a harsh reality check. It's a very harsh reality check. But until there's open communication between parents and kids, this conversation will never happen. If that 20-year-old boy's mother or father actually talked to the 20-year-old openly for an hour, not, hey, you want to get married? Oh, no. Okay, I guess not. That's a one-second conversation. An actual one-hour conversation, they will learn things they never knew about their own child. The problem isn't anything else but communication within them. That communication has to open up. Everything else will become clear. What, there's a lot of things in your kids that you have no idea how. Just talk to them. Just talk to them. And don't terrify them that if they are actually honest, you'll kill them. Let them speak their mind. Yeah, because they're scared. You have to convince them there's nothing to be scared of first. And you have to undo a lot of damage. If they don't talk to you, they're still terrified. They think you're just going to not accept, it'll be completely unacceptable. In the end, you have to go out of your way to get them to open up. Especially teenagers, it's very hard to get them to talk. It's harder than a root canal. You know, your kids don't talk to you. You say, how was your day? Yeah. What'd you do? I don't know. Where are you going? I don't know. Yeah. You know, that's all they do. And then they'll text their friend, my parents are asking me too many questions. Right? And they'll talk to their friend for like hours. Hours. They have so much to say, but not to their parents. Not to their parents. But it's a common problem in our society. You have to work hard you have to keep nudging at it little by little by little until it breaks. And a thing that'll help with that on the side is taking trips with your youth without their cell phones. No texting. Take it away. It's not like their texts are all that awesome anyway. No with 8 O's, or low with 12 L's, or what? Or sub, S-U-P-P-P-P-P. Where are you at? They're sitting next to them, where are you at? That's all they're doing. You know, it's making them socially stunted. They can't carry a normal conversation. You talk to a young person, they're talking to you for a second, and they're like, Take the phone away for a while. Just talk to them. Expect them to be humans. It's going to be hard. But expect them to be humans.